Warri Wolves, Egwekwe. Azubike Egwekwe collecting the first booking of this game. And he wasn't complaining at all, Kelechi.
No complaints there. He was about to be beaten, and if he's been beaten, anything could have been possible. So I think even his manager might not be too angry with him for that sort of a tackle. Dangerous times for Warri Wolves.
And dangerous times it could be. It both headed away. It wasn't a bad free kick, really, coming from Sugar Sambu. And well beaten. A good opportunity, but a hurriedly taken one. And there was no reason, really, for that hurry in the end. Well, I'm sure that supporters of Warri Wolves would have expected something totally different from the referee's decision. But the referee is having none of that.
Very dangerous challenge there, going to Abdullahi. That was actually the number five, Siraj Sadiq. He went in hard on Guido as he tried to head that ball, and he came down hard on the grass. He's really some sort of some spot of water, but I know he will get through that. But Kwara United has really upped the tempo in the last 5 minutes. I think Warri Wolves, they are. The stress is now beginning to show on their players.
And Guido Abulai himself, that must have been some shock. Because given his size, he's quite bulky, he's big, tall and big. And coming all the way down on his back from there could rattle just about anybody. But in the meantime, it is a throw-in. The man taking the throw-in was actually lost in the stands before coming in to heave that one forward. And a chance! And it's finally in! Beautifully done, Akembo. He did not hesitate at all. Slamming that one in. He deserved to score because he's played well so far. It is 35 minutes and we have the first goal of the game. To the home side, Kwara United, following a long throw-in. One of those very long throw-ins they've been having all this while. And well, what can Abunganza can do except have a sip of water? That at least nobody can deny him.
It's been coming and coming and coming, and that was a very, very horrific mistake from Ambrose Van Zeken. He has absolutely nobody to blame. He was with two of his players. Why he couldn't hang on to that one, nobody knows. And that is a murderous mistake to make when someone like Okeyema Akombo is locking behind.
And they have been punished for it. As we have the score.